Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Good evening and welcome to the 81st annual CAC Scandals Jukebox. We are honored to host this event once again in the historic Hallberg Hall Theater. We want to extend a heartfelt thanks to each of you for your support of our show this year. Now we would like to take a moment to recognize the important history of the land that the University of Oklahoma was built upon. Long before David Ross Boyd envisioned the University of Oklahoma, the land we are meeting on today served as a site of meeting and exchange amongst a number of indigenous peoples, such as the Caddo and Wichita and affiliated tribes. Today, 39 tribal nations dwell in the state of Oklahoma as a result of policies that were designated to assimilate native peoples and strip them of their culture. Additionally, many more tribal nations are represented by the native students that attend OU. The Office of Student Life would like to acknowledge that we are visitors on this land. We honor and respect the diverse indigenous peoples connected to this territory on which we gather today. And now please welcome the chair of CAC Scandals, Selena Simmons.
Serving as the executive chair this year. And Scandals is truly a one-of-a-kind experience, and I am so incredibly grateful for this organization for not only giving me some lifelong skills, but also some lifelong best friends. This year, our theme is Jukebox, where each cast was challenged to choose an anthem song and then create an original storyline around it. And this year, they've delved deep into the rhythm, into the world of rhythm and lyrics, and I'm so excited for y'all to see what they've got going on tonight. With that being said, I'd like to give a big thank you to all of the cast members, the directors, for all of their hard work and effort this year. I'd also like to thank my advisors, Kui Nguyen, Hannah Phillips, Jillian Sauer, and London Moore, as well as the rest of Student Life for not only being a resource for me this year, but also supporting me through thick and thin. I'd also like to give a big shout out to the CAC General Counsel for always being a shoulder for me to cry on, literally, several times this year. I'd also like to thank Alex Irwin for inviting me to join his performance committee my freshman year. I literally wouldn't be standing here in front of y'all today if it weren't for his encouragement and for him being an awesome role model. So thank you, Alex. I'd also like to give a big round of applause to George Ryan in the back for announcing the show tonight. As well as the Earl of the Congo for providing us with some live music. Big thank you to my Scandals Executive Committee who's been working since the fall to make all of this happen. I'm so incredibly appreciative of each and every one of you. Thank you, Scandals Exec. And finally, I would like to welcome to the stage the wonderful team of people who've made it all happen, my Vice Chairs. The Executive Vice Chair, Tinley Gomes. The Vice Chair of Finance, Charlie Crawford. Chair of Performance, Liz Worrell. The Vice Chair of Production, Cole Wilson. The Vice Chair of Public Relations, Chase Pride. And the Vice Chair of Community Engagement, Michaela Ponder. For the past year, this team has been working around the clock, whether it's calling a million businesses a week, or stuffing binders until 2 in the morning, so I'm very grateful for all of these people on the stage with me. Doing this experience with some of my best friends has been one of the most rewarding things, so thank you, thank you, thank you. And I have one more piece of business for y'all. Be sure to stay until the end of the show, and after our last number by our performance committee, there's going to be a big QR code on the screen that'll open up to a Google form where you can vote for your crowd favorite, and that'll be open for about 15 minutes after the show. All right, that's all I have for you. Thank you for listening, and sit back, relax, and tune into our jukebox.
We would like to thank some of our sponsors, Callaway House Apartments, Coca-Cola, The Tower Nutrition, Chewy's, Monica Bowls, The Surf Bar, Midway Deli, Oklahoma Craft, Dry Bar, Float Spa, Bricktown Brewery, Laser Away, The Fabrication Lab, and a special thank you to Genealogy and the Fab Lab by Innovation Lab.
just saying, it doesn't make sense if the chicken didn't come first.
But then how did the chicken get there without the egg?
Well, how'd the egg get there without the chicken?
Would you guys drop it already? Jeez.
Are you guys ready to order yet?
I haven't even had a chance to look at the menu, because this bozo over here thinks that the chicken came before the egg.
I mean, how'd the egg get there without the chicken?
I just want to know who's controlling the music in here, because I need something to cover up the sound of their arguing. They never stop.
It's up to you.
What?
The customers control the music, silly. See that jukebox over there? It controls the music for the whole restaurant. You can play whatever you want as long as it's on one of the soundtracks.
Sweet. Come on, guys.
Whoa. Are you guys even going to order?
Whew. I've only got enough in my account for water and breadsticks.
The free stuff?
Sorry, lady.
College kids.
I've never even heard of most of these artists before. What about that one right there, the Scandal soundtrack? What's that? I don't know, it doesn't even seem to have an artist listed.
I mean, you don't have to exactly know the artists that love the music.
Well, what even is Scandals?
Did you say Scandals?
Ah! Who are you?
Where did you come from?
You have to play the Scandal soundtrack.
Why? What's the big deal?
Scandals is so much more than just a soundtrack. It's a whole collection of stories.
Where did you come from?
They're just songs. How good can it be?
Just songs? Oh, no. Get out of my way.
Thank you. really awesome that we get to bring a song to life and get to experience this all together with our instruments.
Scandals has honestly been a really good experience for me. We've gotten to work with like the upperclassmen and the directors to put together all the shows and dances, and it's been really fun. Scandals just has like opened me more to get connected with the people around me, because honestly, without Scandals, I don't think I'd be able to form that community that I have now.
With the new school year starting, Jack is determined to get a second chance with Katie after their breakup last summer. However, Jack is disappointed to find out that Katie has already moved on and is in a relationship with the popular football team captain Tom. With the help of his best friend Louise, will Jack be able to win Katie's heart back? Or will he fumble and be forced to watch from the sidelines? Find out in I Want You Back.
Ah, oh, senior year. You know what that means.
More stress, classes, and tests!
Make it stop! No, Louise. This is going to be the year that I win Katie back.
Yeah!
I should have never broken up with her last summer. Now I know that we belong together.
Aww! Don't be ridiculous, Jack. She's moved on. Now she's dating Tom, the most popular boy in school.
Get your way.
So what?
So what? He's captain of the football team! You're captain of the chess team.
Hi!
I think that speaks for itself.
Ooh, checkmate!
There they are now. I just can't stand seeing them together.
Then maybe you should sit down.
Louise, this is serious. I can already hear them now.
Hello, Tom! You're so awesome and great at football!
I know. Aren't I just so much better than that Jack guy I used to date?
Oh, please, Jack. You might be used to winning all your chess matches, but I think it's time you accept a loss. Or not.
Katie, I have to talk to you.
Jack, what are you doing here?
I should have never broken up with you last summer. I want you back. You deserve so much better than Mr. Tomfoolery over here.
Hey now, do you know who you're talking to?
Oh, please, Tom. You might know your way to the end zone, but there's no chance you know your way to a girl's heart.
Ooh, I'm sorry, Jack, but I've moved on. I'm with Tom now, and you're just going to have to accept that. Yeah, and I'll have to accept an F in English if we're late. Let's go, Jack.
You speak it every day, Louise. I think you'll be fine. Just please help me out. Katie, I just want you back.
Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more.
you're right. The bear might be a little too much.
Not that! You've been treating me like a pawn in one of your little chess games. And I'm tired of being pushed around. Katie this, Katie that. What about me and my feelings?
Your feelings? I think I'm a little lost here.
She likes you!
We've been best friends our whole lives. There's no way.
We need way.
It's true, Jack. I've liked you since I was little. Haven't you noticed how I've always been there for you no matter what? I even laughed at all your chess jokes.
Wait, so you didn't think those were funny?
Definitely not.
That's not important right now. Come on, please say something.
Something?
I never should have said anything. For once, I wanted to be a hopeful romantic, but I guess I'll always be the hopeless one. I know I'm just a fool who's willing to sit around and wait for you. But baby, can't you see?
Call my name, call me there in a hurry. Cause baby, there ain't no mountain high.
you.
It took me long enough.
Louise, I really think you should give him a chance. We've been best friends for so long. Where do we even start?
How about at the beginning? With a first date? So, what do you say?
Yeah, what do you say?
I'd love to.
Hooray!
Yeah! Double date!
Tom, calm down!
No, sorry.
No matter what happens, everything will be all right.
As long as we're together.
Know how that can be.
Disney After Dark might not be everything they had wished upon a star for. Will Andy and Alice be able to keep the magic alive, or will their story end in happily never after? Find out in Powerful Magic.
We finally made it! Mickey's Ultra Powerful Magic Kingdom! Can you believe it?
Sure! Be super loud! Maybe he'll put me out of my misery and they'll kick us out!
Psst, we're not gonna get caught. The park's grand opening is tomorrow morning. Besides, this is the most magical place on Earth. Nothing bad ever happens here.
How many times do I have to tell you magic isn't real? Now let's get out of here before security shows us the magical place of the cold prison cell.
Not before I go ride Splish Mountain over and over and over.
Right over here, officer. Just take him away.
Sorry, allergies.
Hello, welcome to Mickey's Ultra Powerful Magic Kingdom,
where dreams come true.
As you can see, the park isn't even open yet. Come back tomorrow, goodbye. Remember about kids these days.
Mickey, is that really you?
No, Andy, that was some guy in a costume. We should listen to him and go home.
Wait, we can't just leave here only meeting Mickey Mouse. There's gotta be cooler characters around here somewhere.
Oh no, he did it!
No, hold it, mister! You're talking to the face of Disney himself! You ain't never had a friend like me. Hit it!
Down, you ain't never had a friend like me. Now I'm out, like this, your restaurant, and I'm your waiter, Dean. Come on, wait.
girl who finds out we were here.
My ears are ringing. Well, 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 look what we have here. Children who stray too far from home.
Oh my god! Are you Maleficent like the actual Maleficent?
Oh look, we have a fan. Yeah. You slash sweetheart, never meet your heroes.
But you're a villain.
Well, aren't you perceptive? Soon there will be no heroes. With modulating power I stole from Mickey's magic hat, I will seize complete control of the park, its heroes, and its powerful magic. Of the left once the park opens, it's a new Disney park where villains are the main attraction.
How did you get that?
Two words, mouse trap.
Actually, I think that's only one word.
Oh, you're so
I've seen all the Disney movies before, and the villains, they always lose. It'll only be a matter of time before someone stops you.
Well, since you're such a know-it-all, maybe I could use someone like you. Come on.
Thank you. Find out what happens, and I want it all. Not even that 24-hour donut shop?
No, not even that 24-hour donut shop. You'd think after 19 years of living here, I'd finally be chasing my dream.
Here we go again.
No, Theo, I'm serious. Something's different about today. I can feel it. Maybe today's no longer maybe.
What's so wrong with maybe?
Maybe gets you nowhere. If you really want something, you really have to want.
Spat is going on here.
I've got to get back to the city, so either you're coming with me or not.
Oh, I'm going. Whether you or Bettendorf likes it or not.
I can't believe I actually found an artist before the deadline. And she's not that bad. That hasn't happened to me since 1986.
Wait, how old are you?
Oh, that's not important. Anyway, this is so good for me. Oh, I'm sorry, for us. I can practically feel our wallets growing as we speak.
I know! I've always wanted to be a big star! And now the day's finally come!
Yeah, your dreams and all that. Now I really need you to pack. Time is ticking and money is wasting.
Don't you ever talk about anything other than money! Haven't you ever dreamed of being somebody?
I did, a long time ago. But dreams don't pay the bills. You have to work for what you want and make it happen yourself.
Thank you.
making miracles happen.
For bright futures.
For more laughs.
For more birthdays.
For more smiles.
For more dancing.
And you made that happen.
Dance Marathon, Maya Williams.
Hello everyone, my name is Maya Williams and I have the privilege of serving as the Executive Chair of OU Dance Marathon for the upcoming school year. OUDM is OU's largest student-led philanthropy and one of the largest dance marathon programs in the nation. Throughout the year, we work tirelessly to raise money to benefit the Oklahoma Children's Health Foundation in Oklahoma City. And in the past 5 years alone, we've raised over $3 million to ensure the best care for these children. This success would not have been possible without support from our generous donors and our campus community. Today, I invite you all to help by making a difference by donating to your favorite act. To do this, you can Venmo at @OU_dancemarathon and put the name of your favorite show in the memo, or you can visit our table at the entrance of this building. The show with the most money by the end of the week will receive OUDM's Miracle Maker Award. Every donation goes a long way in making a difference in a child's life. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of the shows.
Participating in scandals has really helped me broaden my horizons. This was not something I pictured myself participating in or playing a big role in when I came to college, and it has consumed a lot of my life now, and I'm very, very happy it has. I've learned a lot about myself, I've made so many memories, I've made so many friends that were so, so important to me, and also just kind of got to get out of my comfort zone. That's what college is for, and I really got to flip that out.
Scandals has given me an outlet to continue doing music, which is something I've always loved, and something I didn't think I would continue to get to do in college, so I'm very grateful to Scandals for giving me an outlet to continue that.
We are gonna celebrate!
Rick spends her days working hard on the boatyard while Ben longs for an adventure. One summer afternoon, Ben convinces Britt to take a seemingly abandoned boat for a fun day at sea. Shortly after they set sail, they encounter Megan McFly and Tommy Timehawk and realize that they've traveled back in time using their old boat. Not to fear, Tommy and Megan are experienced time travelers and know how to use the sailboat, but time travel doesn't always work the way they want. Will Megan and Tommy get them back home, or will Ben and Britt be stuck in the past forever? Find out and come sail away.
Sure, it's been a hot minute. Ben, Rick, This is my girl Megan, fellow time traveler.
What are you doing here? I thought we agreed to not use this boat anymore.
Well, I wasn't the one using it. One minute I was enjoying my nap, and the next minute someone pressed a big red button, which clearly shouldn't be pressed.
I'm sorry, I panicked.
On the other hand, she wasn't the one driving it.
It seemed like a good idea at the time.
Regardless, even if you weren't watching the boat, what happened to the old man warning people?
Oh, he was serious about that? That's the most cliche warning of all time.
Well, we wanted it to be obvious not to drive the boat.
Wait, so we actually time traveled? Well, how were you on the boat the whole time? And why didn't you stop us?
How does a time traveling boat even exist in the first place?
A lot of questions and no answers until you answer mine. What were you all doing stealing a boat?
Okay, she was the one who pressed the button. You're totally fine until she freaked out like that.
Both of you messed up. Luckily, Tommy and I are experienced time travelers, and we can get you guys back. Right, Tommy?
Of course, students. We'll sail right back through time.
Oh, now I get why it's called the sail time, because we're literally sailing through time.
Yeah, we got that already.
I'm sailing away, set an open course for the virgin sea. On board the captain, so climb aboard. We'll search for tomorrow on every shore, and I'll try, oh Lord, I'll try to carry on. Come sail away, come sail away.
Seven, going up straight up in the post. I shouldn't have convinced you to take the boat. That was really irresponsible of me.
You think?
Prince!
I'm kidding. Tommy, Megan, thank you for everything.
You're welcome. We knew you'd work it out.
We just wanted you guys to learn that you had to work together if you wanted to make it back home. And now that you have, let's get back to the present.
Some of our sponsors, Cowboy House Apartments, Coca-Cola, The Tower Nutrition, Chewy's, Monica Bowls, The Surf Bar, Midway Deli, Oklahoma Craft, Dry Bar, Float Spa, Bricktown Brewery, Laser Away, The Fabrication Lab, and a special thank you to Genealogy and the Fab Lab by Innovation Lab. And also please welcome the 2024 CAC Scandals Combo on trumpet, Mr. Jim Rachel. James Keyes. And on keyboards are our musical director, Mr. Michael Turner.
Thank you.
everything to me is it's a family. You know, I'm a senior, and you know, coming a part of this really gets me involved again. And I love seeing everybody's faces, you know. I'm a smiley guy, and seeing everybody smile together just so happy, so I'm glad to be a part of this.
I would tell someone that's considering participating in panels to 100% do it. I've done it my past 4 years in college, and I'm honestly, like, it brings tears to my eyes to think that I won't be doing this next year. So, you know, if you've never done theater before, you've never danced, you've never been able to sing in front of people, it doesn't matter, just do it. It's so much fun.
Songs, but it wasn't always this way. The Jets started as a group of misfits trying to make a name for themselves in the music industry. As they perform in front of a small crowd, the band faces a pivotal moment when Bennie, a legendary figure, walks into the scene. The members of the Jets see this as an opportunity to elevate their status in the music world. However, Bennie, initially disinterested, dismisses the idea of joining the band. How did they manage to convince Bennie to join the band? Find out in Bennie and the Jets.
Oh, you're being serious. Be honest with yourself, Benny. You haven't had a hit in 10 years. Ooh. Your label ditched you. Ooh. And let's face it, you don't have the moves like you used to. Ooh. Anyways, what I'm trying to say is your career is toast, and we're the better.
Oh! Look, my singing days are behind me. And besides, my cholesterol's too high for butter anyway. I'm not joining your band!
Wait!
Taking risks, facing fears, and sharing your passion with the world.
Ozzy. Trust us, you have what it takes. Now let's show them what we're made of.
Okay, hit it.
Let's go!
the Duke of Headington for approach in 30 minutes, and following would have the typical post-punk.
I don't want to be the king anymore.
Oh, you are too funny, Mr. King. Why did you
know you made that sound? I'm being serious.
Oh no, a midlife crisis. Oh, what's next? A Bronco? A Mustang? My life is over.
Horse, it has nothing to do with you. And hey, you'll always be my favorite horse.
You know how much paperwork I have to do now?
Oh, whatever.
A 2 weeks would have been nice.
Get today's news, Hodgman!
Fresh vegetables over here!
You have to put your back into it!
It's Amber Grumman! Oh my God! Cassidy! You would not believe the morning I just had. My family's found in Berkeley!
No, we should have!
The head played 10 eggs and you had no! And now about me, how's your day?
Oh, it's been fine.
Cassidy, you've been stuck in this shop your whole life. It's time for you to get out of here. See the world. Meet new people.
Oh, I know, Kat, but this is my home, and as much as I want a new adventure, my family needs me.
Well, at least keep an open mind. For all you know, an incredible opportunity can come running out of nowhere.
Hear ye, hear ye, a message from the king.
Oh, the king has quit. I know, but protocol is protocol. Do we have any volunteers?
Oh, no, Kat, what are you...
Perfect! All hail the queen!
Yeah!
Alright, the royal coronation will be taking place.
Right?
I'm not sure about
do
this.
Do you... what's your name?
Cassie?
Do you, Cassie, hereby solemnly swear to protect the kingdom with your full heart, mind, and soul, valuing the lives and well-being of the public, of your own personal life, at all costs.
Yeah, I'm okay.
Perfect! Ladies and gentlemen, I present Queen Cassie.
I think there's been a misunderstanding. I can't be the queen.
Too late.
Free coffee and croissants on the house!
Yeah! Are we there yet?
Patience,
I know we're close. The king has always talked about opening his own bakery and... Did you know her since only been one day?
Mr. King, sir.
Well, hi, what's her name?
Cassie.
Queen Cassie.
Your Majesty, what can I do for you?
I came to ask for some advice.
Hit me.
Okay, so I'm not really sure about this whole queen thing.
What do you mean?
I mean, how is someone able to handle all of this? What did you do?
Well, I left. I mean, as the king, I tried to do what was best for the kingdom, even if it meant sacrificing what mattered to me the most. I wish somebody would have told me that my dreams were just as important as everyone else's.
Well, then what should I do?
Well, I had to find my own path, and now so do you. Everyone shall sit under their own vine and fig tree. No one shall make them afraid. Be safe in this kingdom, leave.
Let's not so be your girl. I'm a big really a fun and entertaining way to think about it as a great way to get involved with the organization and to really perform.
Scandals have allowed me to foster more relationships within my organization. Sometimes it's harder to get to know the freshmen and the seniors, so getting to see them every week in practice has been great, and also just getting to bond with the guys has been super fun and creating lifelong friendships.
We are Dragon Boy!
Christine, Liz, how do you have this much energy this early in the morning?
You know Stevie will fire us if we're late.
What a tragedy that would be.
Oh, come on!
Thank you.
all like working together, just long Stevie, what if we left and did our own thing? A good old-fashioned union.
Workers unite!
That sounds great in theory, but how would we ever have even a fraction of the success that we had working under Stevie? She built this thing from the ground up.
Think about it. We basically do all the work for her and the only way she works. All she is going for her is her name.
Exactly. There's power in numbers, and we have those. I know it seems scary, but if we all stick together, we could build something even bigger than Toonsville. Here's how it goes.
Nobody's. Oh, that was easy. Once we realized you're actually the ones following up the clients,
brainstorming through the studio, into, oh, I don't know, producing your music? The rest just kind of fell in place.
But that company was mine!
Doesn't matter. Once we told them how you actually are, nothing will want to work with you again anyways.
I can't believe it!
We couldn't either. Despite everything you told us, work doesn't have to be miserable.
Yeah, since we've been gone, we've realized it's actually possible to like where you work.
And like who your boss is.
Okay.